take my whole life too. Oh, for I can't help falling in love with you. Wise men only fools rush in.
Some people live for the fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power, yeah. Some people live just to play the game. Some people need 3 dozen roses, and that's the only way to prove you love them. Hand me the world on a silver platter, and what good would it be? No one to share. Nothing in this whole world don't mean a thing if I ain't got you with me, baby.
Who gives this woman to be joined in holy matrimony?
I do.
Jim, do you and Diana accept Albert into your hearts and into your family?
We do.
Al, do you and Sally accept Chauvin into your hearts and into your family?
Yes, we do.
Shall we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, we come here today for this beautiful celebration of marriage of Chauvin and Albert. We pray that your spirit will not only be with them today, but for the rest of their lives. Chauvin and Albert have already received the greatest gift of falling in love and being gifted with Riker. May you continue to enrich their lives through this marriage sacrament and direct their journey so that they can share their talents with all whom they encounter along their paths. Amen. Good afternoon. We would like to thank you and welcome you today for this beautiful celebration of marriage. As I look around at all of you, I see uniqueness, love, and elegance. And with this uniqueness, love, and elegance, we are creating a oneness of unity for Chauvin and Albert. Both Chauvin and Albert have been blessed with many talents from their rich heritages. Both come from loving families. Each of you has nurtured them through love, guidance, and support. And today is the day that they want to share that love with each of you. Chauvin wrote a beautiful statement to her parents last year on their anniversary, and it was so eloquently spoke about love that I would like to share that with you. To my beautiful parents, we should all be so blessed to have a marriage like yours. Thank you for setting such a high standard for me, for what a relationship should be. Your marriage is the happiest and healthiest one that I've ever witnessed. And the love and respect you have for each other knows no bounds. You are a constant inspiration to me, and you've taught me the greatest lesson that you can teach someone, and that is how to love unconditionally. So thank you, Chauvin. One of my favorite scriptures is found in Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. It states, "Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you." Now in life and in love and in marriage, there's many knocks along the way. And many of these knocks will push you down. But Chauvin, you and Albert, remember that the door is always opened if you ask. As your love deepens, may it be an inspiration to others. Chauvin and Albert have written their own vows that they would like to share with you.
I have to check an email real quick.
Do you need the microphone?
Can you guys hear me? Should I do the microphone?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Put the mic in between.
Hello?
Hello?
Okay. Mine are short and sweet, dear.
Okay. Mine are long. Maybe I should go first.
Yeah, it's whatever you'd like to do. You're always right. whatever you want to do. I can go. I'll go first. First off, I vow to be fun. I vow to be present, to love you, to hold your hand, and to compliment you. I vow to be your equal, your provider, your protector, your best friend, and your problem solver. I vow to let you win the arguments, to support you through the ups and downs, to make you smile, to keep you on your toes, and to get better as the days go by. Lastly, with a little tradition mixed in, just because I feel like, you know, a little bit of the old, a little bit of the new, a little bit of my flavor of vows, and then what is tradition. I vow to be your wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part. I love you, babe.
Well, mine are a little longer than that. I actually struggled with these vows, and the reason as to why this was such a challenge for me is not because I didn't know what to say, but rather I didn't know what I should leave out. There's so much that I love about you, about our relationship, our family, and the life that we have built together. I could go on for days, including everything from how much I love coming downstairs on Saturday mornings to jazz music and you and Riker making pancakes, to how fired up you get about superhero movies and all that lies in between.
They're great.
I want you to know how much I appreciate and adore all the little things. However, to keep this fairly short, it is the big things that I'm going to mention. I have so much respect and admiration for you. You impress me every day with how driven and ambitious you are. You excel at everything you do, and you constantly make me want to better myself. Your success has come with integrity, and you never compromise your morals or values to achieve what you are, or to achieve what you are after in life, and that is such a commendable thing. Most people don't have. You are a good man, and that seems like such a simple statement, but it is incredibly rare to find in this day and age. You have such a good heart, and I know there is nothing that you wouldn't do for your loved ones and family, and the kindness that you show to complete strangers is the first thing about you that I fell in love with. But I fall in love with you every day. You're always surprising me with how creative and funny you are, and you make me laugh, and not the type of laugh that's out of courtesy for the person's feelings, but a genuine laughter. That's a difficult feat to pull off when it comes to me, because I am a tough critic. I fall even more in love with you every time I see you with our son. You're such an amazing father, and Riker and I could not be luckier to have you in our lives. You're an incredible example for both of us, and I can only hope that Riker turns out to be just like his daddy. I could go on. I probably have, but there's too much to cover. It would take me a lifetime. Fortunately for you, we have a lifetime together. Sucker. And I vow to remind you of all these wonderful traits that you possess on a regular basis. I vow to remember all the incredible things that make you, you. And the times when we find ourselves in troubled waters, because we will find ourselves in troubled waters. All relationships do. But in the moments of struggle, I will remind myself that I know you, and that I know your heart, and that you and our relationship and our family are worth all the effort that it may take to keep us afloat. It is easy to be the ideal partner when everything is going great. My vow to you is that I will be your ideal partner in times of strife. I will always protect what we have built together. I will always put you and our family before everything else, including myself. I will love you always, and I will always choose to love you over the other emotions that I may be feeling towards you at the time. I vow to treat every moment that I have with you as if it were our last moment together. Because we are only given a short amount of time on this earth, and I intend to make the most of it by living it out the rest of the days of my life with you by my side. I love you.
Shall we proceed with the ring ceremony? Albert, do you take Shobin to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you vow to love her, honor her, comfort her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Shobin. Oops, we'll wait. Do you take Albert to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you vow to love him, honor him, comfort him, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Whereas you have mutually pledged to each other to be husband and wife, keeping the holy bonds of marriage, I, by the virtue of Jesus Christ, do hear and now solemnly pronounce you man and wife. Albert, you may kiss your wife. It is my privilege and my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Albert Briggs. Thank you.
when I'm old and grown. I won't sleep alone. Whoa. Every single moment will be faded into you. That's some type of love. That's some type of love. And I won't sing the blues, 'cause all I need is you. Whoa. Every single question will be answered all by you. That's some type of love. That's some type of love. When the world's on fire, we won't even move. There is no reason if I'm here with you. And when it's said and done, I'll give me to you. That's some type of love. That's some type of love. That's some type of love. That's some type of love.
Next, we are introducing Colby Ray Brawner and Keith Pinkelman. And now we have the maid of honor and the best man, Chelsea Tooker and Ryan Matheson. Next up, the father and mother of the bride, Jim and Diana Eustis. Next up is the father and mother of the groom, Al and Sally Briggs. Together for the bride and the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Albert Briggs.
Every single moment will be faded into you. That's some type of love. That's some type of love. And I won't sing the blues. Cause all I need is you. Whoa. Every single question will be answered all by you. That's some type of love. That's some type of love. When the world's on fire, we won't even
have the first dance.
That's full of fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live just to play a game. Some people think that the physical things define what's within. And I've been there before. That life's a bore, so full of the superficial. So
nothing at all.
Feeling you, baby. I got you, baby. Some people want diamond rings. Some just want everything. But everything means nothing. I ain't got you. Yeah. Some people search for a fountain. Promises forever young. Some people need 3 dozen roses, and that's the only way to prove you love them. And we don't know on a silver platter. And what good it be? Share with no one who truly cares for me. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if I ain't got it, you, baby. Some people want diamond rings. Some just want everything.
Now we can have Jim Eustace step to the dance floor for the father-daughter dance.
You are everything. Yep.
It's on. I hear it.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. Freebird!
I wanted to go extemporaneous, but that's not good. So here we are. We made it. We made it to Cabo. I can't tell you. Welcome. On behalf of Sally and Al and Diane and myself, welcome. I can't put into words how much it means to me to see all of you here. It's really important to me. Chauvin.
Yes.
There you are. Chauvin, I'm going to quote. I see if you recognize this quote. And it's, the quote is, Chauvin, what can I say? Chauvin is Chauvin.
That's
that was a quote from her kindergarten teacher. at our very first parent-teacher meeting. And we went into the meeting with the high hopes of hearing, oh, Chauvin is a genius, brilliant. And it's certainly a candidate for a Nobel Prize. But no, it really wasn't that. She probably was saying that that Chauvin is a loving, loyal, smart, truthful, strong, nurturing, independent, creative, and has sort of a sense of humor. That's my interpretation of the meeting, and I'm sticking to that. Yeah. Now I haven't ruled out the Nobel Prize just yet. Now that I've revealed my parental bias, let me share the concern of every father who has a daughter. There's nobody worthy of their hand in marriage. I think we can all of those. However, there is always hope. And with hope, there's power of prayer. And this has been our prayer. I'm going to be a little bit serious here. Dear God, Heavenly Father, thank you for blessing us with our daughter, Chauvin. Please bring her a relationship of mutual love and respect, one that will enable both to live their lives to the fullest. In difficult times, give them the strength to guide each other and the wisdom to accept each other's counsel. When they need each other the most, they will support one another, and they will be reminded that when they are together, they will always be safe and loved. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Chauvin and Albert, when I look at the two of you today, I know that our prayer has been answered. So I want you to join me in the raise your glasses for those who took the Irish whiskey. Fine, for those who had the champagne, that's probably even better. And with that, may the divine spirit always be in your hearts. May your loving family and friends remain close to you. And may the love that brought you together endure and thrive.
Hello.
Cheers.
Hello.
Cheers.
Hey, Daddy.
Now the next one up, best man.
Okay.
Ryan.
We put all of this together.
Yeah. Your booze up there. First of all,
happy birthday to my beautiful fellow bridesmaid, Colby. I don't know if you guys know it's her
happy birthday
today. Raise your hand, lovey. Happy birthday. She's 21. It's great. Okay, so throughout the night tonight, we were asking everyone to raise a glass to Chauvin and Albert to celebrate, to honor, and to remember that as soon as we quench that thirst, the thirst begins again. It's a symbol of marriage. I want Chauvin and Albert to learn that the minute you exhaust the amount of love you give or receive, the love dies. It needs to remain free-flowing and forever fleeting, never caught, never owned, and never won. Chauvin and Albert cannot begin their journey as man and wife without acknowledging where they came from. To Al and Sally, Where are they? Oh. You already know the type of man you have raised, but from the few years I have known Albert, he has surpassed my immeasurable expectations for my chauvin. He is patient, he is genuine, he is tall. He is a thoughtful and observant friend. He is an all-giving and devoted father, which proves to be his most important accomplishment. Albert is also a pretty good dancer, but he's not as good as me. Which girl is dancing? If I ever shut up. To Jim and Diana. Although raising Chauvin has proven fulfilling, exhausting, entertaining, expensive, and proud, by far her greatest accomplishment has been the cute little nugget in the dapper white suit. She demonstrates unwavering loyalty. She is passionate. She is elegant. She is kind. Clearly characteristics she has mimicked from the extraordinary marriage example she had growing up. Personally, without the love and guidance Jim and Diana selflessly gave me only a few years ago, I know I would not be standing here as the young woman and mother I am today. So, we raise our glasses to Al, Sally, Jim, and Diana. It's only half the page. Kidding. Chauvin and I have been friends since we were 5 years old, and I am sure Jocelyn and Vince can attest we are quite a handful. When I got married 2 years ago, I wrestled with the inability to let go of Chauvin as my person and allow Ryan to take over. Someone's person, to me, is that one human being in our lives that will literally drop their lives to be there for yours. They cry, laugh, yell, curse, argue, sleep, stay up, hug, hit, smash, run, stay, drive, fly, sprint, lounge, celebrate, and mourn right alongside you. They can read your mind, anticipate your next move, and call your bullshit. We all have that person. That one human we can't get rid of, no matter how hard we try. Yeah. Not that we would want to. Chauvin has been there for me and my family in ways that are immeasurable and noteworthy. They are acts of nothing short of heroic. But as Albert and Chauvin say their I do's today, I too must pass the torch. Now, to Albert, to become Chauvin's person. Albert, you need to cry, laugh, yell, curse, argue, sleep, stay up, hug, hit, smash, run, stay, drive, fly, sprint, lounge, celebrate, and mourn right along with my Chauvin.
Yeah.
And you better do it with the grace, ease, and beauty that I have done it with. Marriage is about fulfilling your dreams and your hopes for the future with your best friend and partner right alongside you. So for now, Chauvin, our chapter as each other's person has ended, and Albert's can begin. Let's raise our glasses to quench our thirst for the single second, for this love should and will be forever fleeting. Cheers.
Let's go dance. Yeah. There's a slow-mo photo booth over there, too.
Wow.
That's kind of dope.
It's a short version.
Not that one?
No, I don't know.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Aquí están los tenedores.
I see I want your high love anymore.
good friend around me. Cause you're a good girl and you know it. I know exactly who you could be. Oh, just hold on, I'm going home. Just hold on, I'm going home. It's hard to do these things alone. Hold on, I'm going on.
Going on.
Oh, oh, oh.
Going on.
Hold on.
Happiness is the truth. Okay guys, are you ready? 1, 2, 3.